Alright. Yeah, there we go. Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. Welcome to Fancy Times with John. See, this glass has my name on it. You could thank Cameron and his wonderful wife for supplying this glass and supplying my habits. So, I've talked a lot on this channel about Kingdom Hearts before, so I thought it'd be fun if I tried to recap from memory the plot of Kingdom Hearts, just in general. I mean, I've only played the first two games, but I have a basic idea of what happens in the later games, you know? So, yeah, this is going to be your primer for before Kingdom Hearts 3 comes out in January of 2019. I was going to say 2020. Okay, so we begin on Destiny Islands. There's Sora, there's Riku, there's Kairi, a whole bunch of these fucking Final Fantasy kids. But they're Final Fantasy X kids, so I'm cool with it. I love them. I love those boys. Waka and Titus. They are just... I love Final Fantasy X so much. It made me so happy to see them just because... they were like my first foray into like... God, and they... It was weird though because they were like little tiny children. And that was kind of off-putting. Yeah, they have parents. Which, it doesn't really make any sense for the context of the rest of the series, but... Okay, whatever. Yeah, they have parents. They're fucking around on this island. They're like, hey, yo, we all like each other, right? Like, Sora's like, Riku, I really like you. Riku's like, I like you a lot too, Sora. Kairi's like, I'm just here. Nobody cares. And then shit happens. Sora goes to sleep, and then he wakes up. And then there's, like, these like, darkness and stuff. They also get into an argument about naming a boat and who wants to date Kairi. But I feel like this is just, like, a... You know, they both pretend to like this one girl because they're secretly in love with each other. Anywho. This darkness comes. They get they get separated. I was going to say they get disapparated. Traverse Town. He wakes up there. We meet Donald and Goofy. You know, King Mickey, all this stuff. All of the Disney guys. Horrible, horrible husbands. They're horrible husbands. They leave their wives. They don't care about them. Bam, the Sora's doing stuff, and then, yada yada yada, they all meet up. Sora meets up with Donald and Goofy, they become best friends. They start traveling the universe. They start traveling to all these different worlds, Tarzan and all this shit, and then... A lot of stuff happens, a lot of grinding. We meet Hercules, we meet Cloud, which is super dope, because it's like, Cloud? Cloud? Maleficent's doing something... Hades is doing something. All this stuff happens. Sora gets turned into a Heartless. That's important for later. But then they all come together, and Sora and Riku and King Mickey all come together, and they close Kingdom Hearts, and they stop Ansem. By the way, Ansem's the bad guy. Kind of. So Ansem's the bad guy, and they stop him, close Kingdom Hearts. Then a lot of other stuff happens. Okay, so, bam, Chain of Memories happens. Basically, all you need to know, there's a card game, and Sora loses his memory and goes into, like, a hyperbolic time chamber pod thingy. Bam, Kingdom Hearts 2, we meet Roxas. Roxas is great, I don't care what the fuck you say. That intro level is fun, and all the jobs are fun, and everything about it's fun, and I like Roxas, and I'm sad about what happens to him. Anywho, so, we meet Roxas, he's his kid. There's all this weird stuff happening. There's these things called nobodies. They're all doing this whole thing. That whole thing. And then... Then basically we find out that Roxas is Sora's nobody. So when you turn into a Heartless, your shell that's left over becomes a nobody. Cool. Makes sense. Whatever. So Sora gains his memories back, wakes up. Him, Donald, and Goofy are going on another quest to find Riku because they lost Riku. All this other stuff happens. We go to these other Disney worlds. There's this evil organization, Organization 13. They got these dope black cloaks. They look really cool, and you're never gonna get tired of seeing them, ever. Now I'm just trying to legitimately remember what happens, and I'm like, I'm drawing a blank here. Like, legitimately, I remember going to the worlds, and I remember the organization members would keep showing up, and you'd fight them, and then they go away. And then eventually they open up this giant fortress that you have to, like, attack. And then it turns out that this old man was Riku the entire time for some reason. Which, I mean, the ending boss fight of Kingdom Hearts 2 is bomb. It's amazing. It's spectacular. I really love it. It's Sora and Riku fighting for the first time together against a common enemy, Xehanort, who is... Xehanort is Ansem's nobody. Xemnas. No, oh no. Win the day, they go back to Destiny Islands, they meet up with Kairi, and then they get a letter from King Mickey that says something else is coming. Bam! Cool. So that's all of that, and then there's all the games that I didn't play. So basically, you find out that back in the day, there are these three keyboard warriors, Aqua, Ventus, and Roxas, whatever. And then Xehanort, one of the X guys is like a Keyblade Master, and he's evil, and he puts his soul into these people, and then people die, and then they put their hearts in other people, and there's multiple versions of the same people, and Kingdom Hearts 3 comes out next year. I'm sorry, I can't do it. I can't do it.